Why we're all here this evening. I'm so glad that you're present and I share your feelings. This is the worst economic times facing public education in our lifetime. We actually have two choices, and the board has actually two choices. Bad and worse. The board has directed me to make recommendations. And I have come up with a list that obviously you have a copy of. A major push from the Department of Education is to keep these cuts away from classroom teachers. So the things that you see on the list and the things that you're concerned about most is what Dr. Bennett wants or is recommending, frankly, us to cut the classroom teachers. And so what I'd like to do is go through these items, but first I want to look at items 3 and 9. And they are nurses and WEEM radio. I am very concerned about the safety of our at-risk students in eliminating nurses. I recall a meeting not too long ago with the nurses, and I told them that I don't believe that I could recommend reducing nurses. And I don't feel any differently today than I did previously. My concerns are just the same. We got medically at-risk students, nine of them are nurses. Yet, once again, I was charged with coming up with a list of options. Number 9, the WEEM radio. It has not been mentioned that I've been working with Mr. Petrie and Mr. Smith for over a year and working out a partnership with a university to have a dual program that would be a win-win for both university or college located here in Pendleton, and at the same time keep our station at the high school and share some costs. Those discussions are ongoing. It would certainly be premature for me to make a recommendation to eliminate the WEEM program without that discussion being completed. Mr. Petrie and Mr. Smith, over the last year, have worked to receive their licenses to teach at the university level. And I envision that our students could not only take classes at the high school, but take university classes nearby and take additional classes. So with these two items, even though they are on the list, I will not be recommending those for elimination on February the 11th. Now understand, I'm just the superintendent. I don't make those decisions. I just present options and make recommendations. And the Board of School Trustees will make that decision. We did a study of our teachers comparing their salary but their insurance benefits. I can give this to anybody. Contrary to what you may be hearing, I just showed this to a member of ISDA. And I asked the person, is this an accurate, are these accurate figures? Does this really display what our teachers are making compared to other districts? I don't want to release that person's name right now, but the person said, yes, it does. ISDA is against the Teachers Association. And here's what the results are. If you look at the insurance, what teachers pay, what we pay on salary, at the time this was taken, teachers are paid in the top 10 of all the districts in the state of Indiana. We are making a valiant effort to pay teachers as much as we can, that we rank in the top 10, not in salaries, but if you compare our salaries with the insurance benefits attached to them, we rank among the top in the state. And about 297.
Top 10.
Now, this study was done a couple of months ago. Some districts have settled. I would say to you that this information may have changed in the last couple of months. But if you've heard that teachers in the South Madison districts are the lowest paid in the state, that is actually very untrue. Because the money that we pay for insurance costs the same amount as we pay for salaries. A dollar here, a dollar there, it's the same. The dollar we pay for insurance is still a dollar. And you have to look at, everything. Yeah, it is taxpayer dollars. And so the district has had a history of having this Cadillac model. And we know what happened to General Motors. Don't we? I'm telling you, I don't want it to happen to South Madison. Because we have had a 27% increase in insurance in the last 2 years total. And when you look at a plan that costs $23,000 and you multiply that increase, you're talking a lot of money that's added on extra every year. And we simply cannot afford it. Now, as a superintendent, I'm telling you, I wish I didn't have to tell you this. And just take the easy way out and not avoid these, what I call, courageous conversations. But I'm sharing with you, we've got to make tough decisions, and we need to do it in a spirit of cooperation. But the information has to be out there so you know what the problems are. Now, I believe, in my heart of hearts, that Margaret Eversole, who I consider a friend, is going to work with us to find a solution to this. Mrs. Eversole is a media specialist at the high school and also is the president of the Classroom Teachers Association. And we've had conversations and we are committed to resolving this issue. And I believe we're going to get it done so that we don't have to cut these things.